Hi. In this video, we'll explain the purpose and nature of the ALEKS assessments that are central to student mastery. Students in ALEKS will be assessed at the beginning of their course and periodically throughout their learning. These assessments are called knowledge checks. There are different types of knowledge checks, and they're triggered for different reasons. Knowledge checks are critical to students' learning in ALEKS and ensure that students stay on an optimal path to success. All knowledge checks in ALEKS are adaptive, individualized, and open response. Their main purpose is to determine what each student knows and is most ready to learn in order to deliver a personalized learning path that remains optimal throughout the learning experience. Some knowledge checks in ALEKS are comprehensive, asking questions from topics spanning the entire course. Other knowledge checks focus on recent student learning, which are called progress knowledge checks. The first knowledge check every student will take in ALEKS is the initial knowledge check. This averages about 25 questions. The purpose of this knowledge check, which is a comprehensive type of assessment, is to determine each student's starting point in the course. Which topics do they already know? Which topics remain? And which of those remaining topics is the student most ready to learn? The results of each knowledge check are presented to the student as a pie chart, which is a graphical representation of the entire content of the course. This pie chart uses shading of the slices to show students how much of the course they know and how much they have left to learn. Some knowledge checks are automatically triggered periodically throughout a student's learning. These types of knowledge checks are progress knowledge checks and are triggered by different metrics. The metrics ensure that the assessment occurs often enough in order to increase retention and ensure mastery. Let's take a closer look at how these knowledge checks are triggered. Here is an example comparing the learning paths of two students and when they receive knowledge checks. After the initial knowledge check, they begin their learning. Student A spends 5 hours in ALEKS and learns about 20 topics. This triggers a progress knowledge check. Student B, on the other hand, has reached 10 hours since his last knowledge check, but hasn't learned 20 topics yet. However, this will trigger a progress knowledge check. Another common trigger is the post-objective knowledge check. Per the instructor's setting, students will get a knowledge check once they complete each objective in the course, or the due date occurs, whichever happens first. The timer for these knowledge checks is reset any time a student completes any type of knowledge check. There are also built-in time spans where knowledge checks are blocked. For example, if a student reaches the last 10 topics of an objective, like student A, or the due date is within 48 hours, like student B, progress knowledge checks will be blocked. All of this keeps the student from being over-assessed. From their homepage, students can select this icon here to see when their next progress knowledge check will occur. They may be able to postpone the knowledge check for up to 24 hours if they need more time, depending on the instructor's setting. Some knowledge checks occur based on the instructor scheduling them for a specific time or date range. They can also make it proctored and require students to take it on campus. To schedule these, go to the Assignments menu and select Assignments. Select New Assignment and choose Scheduled Assessment. You can then customize the scheduled assessment, such as setting the date and time it's due or making it proctored. To see data on your students' knowledge checks, go to the Reports menu and select Progress Report. The default view will show the results of the latest knowledge check each student has taken. The outcome of the knowledge check is illustrated here in a progress bar. You can also see when the student began and completed each knowledge check. To view the results of all knowledge checks for each student, go to the Show menu and select Detailed Progress History. You'll see all of the knowledge checks each student has taken up to this point. Comparing the differences between each knowledge check can be key to ensuring that students are making regular progress. For example, as long as each knowledge check result increases from the previous one, you know that the student is making regular progress in the course. To view even more details, select the date in the assessment column. You'll be taken to the individual student's pie report. This report shows you which topics the student mastered, which topics they provisionally learned, and which topics are remaining, based on what they demonstrated on each knowledge check. This information can be more valuable than viewing a simple list of problems the student got right and wrong. Instead, ALEKS takes it a step further to assess which topics the student can demonstrate mastery of and which ones they still need to practice. For example, this student mastered 292 topics so far in the course, based on their latest knowledge check. But what about the topics she didn't master, even though they had provisionally learned them? These topics remain in the learned category. On the student's dashboard, the Needs More Practice tile lists the topics the student missed on the knowledge check. In other words, they provisionally learned them, but have yet to demonstrate mastery of them on a knowledge check. Students will also have this tile on their own reports dashboard. If a student wants to work on these particular topics, they enter into learning mode, open the topic carousel, and select Needs More Practice from the topics filter list. Encourage your students to select this filter after each knowledge check so that they can remediate quickly. Last, at the class level dashboard, check out the Lost in Recent Assessment tile to see which topics the majority of students need more practice on. You can then focus on these topics as part of a class review. I hope you found this video tutorial helpful. If you ever have any technical questions about ALEKS, contact ALEKS Customer Support through your ALEKS inbox for the quickest response. For contact hours, visit www.alex.com/support. Thanks for watching. We wish you the best of luck in your math course.